Thank you. Oh, you're too kind. Too kind. Too kind, you guys. I got to run and get some coffee. So, yeah. All right, so we're going to have, how about we do this? I got something. Here we go. You guys will like this one. right already. Oh boy, I tell you. You got a Marianne and Ginger and the fat ass captain. Boy, you couldn't beat. What a group, huh? What a group, I tell you. Car 54, where are you? I can't do my siren song because I don't, my siren sound effect, because I don't have my sound effect stuff with me. Although I do got this one here. It's I don't know, squirrels or squirrels or chipmunks, you know. Those guys, I got them hanging around, but anyway, the wife, you know, she doesn't like them to be in the house, you know, squirrels, or who would? But anyway, my new old sponsor is going to be this, I don't know, maybe you've heard of this stuff before, guys. Well, I got to get something straight if Linda's out there and ever listens to this. Linda, this is just a hobby of mine, honey. I've never went to Brown Institute, although a few institutions wanted me to check in. But nonetheless, well, you know about that. I tell you what, that stuff ain't funny anymore, eh? You know what I'm saying? This is Carla Slingblade. You guys better listen up to Captain Boomer once in a while. He got an IQ at least 170. Well, maybe not that high. Anyway, anyway, and I do this, Linda, because number one, I can, and it keeps me, I feel alive when I do this. I feel like just maybe I might be able to make a little bit of difference in somebody's life. Maybe. I know I might be wishful thinking, but you know, it beats sitting around and banging your head against the wall and wondering what's going on in the world, because boy, I'm telling you, it's, yeah. See, there you go. You can't, it's hard nowadays not to dwell on what, to a certain degree, on what is happening out there. And it's not good, most of it. So anyways, but I'm not...
What wheels on the bus go round and round?
Oh, yeah, my granddaughter. I used to sing it to my granddaughters, and he used to sing it to me.
Wheels on the bus go round and round.
And Linda, once in a while, you're going to see me on Facebook out there. I put goofy stuff on and just try to get a few laughs here and there and stuff like that there. Yeah, so that's what I do. And anyway, I'm going to play my own song here. It's not the best. Of course, I don't have fancy sound equipment. Everything that you hear, experience with the old Captain Boomer podcast, there's no filters, there's no nothing. It's just all, it's a captain being crazy, having fun, a little bit of my hobby, that's it. And don't read more into it, because there is nothing more to read into it. this is just a little way that I cope. Is kind of a hard, getting a hard word to cope in, some the world to cope in sometimes. But anyway, that's what it is. And I hope you guys can find your own sanctuary. There you go. Thank you. Kind of a little sanctuary for me. And I don't know, when I do this, it seems to me that things aren't quite as bad as they probably really are. But anyway, it's what I need. It's what I do. It helps me, gets me through my day. And like the Rolling Stones, whatever the song said, whatever gets you. No, that was the Beatles. Whatever gets you through the night, it's all right. It's all right. That was John Lennon, I believe. Anyway, okay. And we have contests here once in a while, Linda. One of our big contests was we have a skin tag contest where the Boomers send in pictures of their skin tags. And I believe a gal from Forest Lake here won it here last, I think it was last month we had the skin tag contest. Oh, yeah, we have all the varicose veins. You know, it's just stuff that us Boomers, you know, have and put up with and that we experience as we do get older. You damn right. And don't forget, guys, it's National Boomer Day today. Wear tie-dye, have a sit-in, make the peace sign, smoke a joint, for sure smoke a joint. That's right. There you go. It makes sense to me. Anyways, there you go. All right, we're going to go. Oh, yeah, this is what they say about the old captain here. The Mars Magazine people, I don't know if you guys heard about the Mars Magazine people, but they are, to me, they are even a better source venue for information for Boomers than the ARP people. Okay, Mars stands for Medicated and Retired Seniors. And yes, they have a magazine out there, and you can only get the subscription through Captain Boomer Podcast. So get a hold of my people. And no, I don't have any people. Yeah. Anyways, They say of the captain, they say he's 3 bricks short of a load. Not playing with a full deck. Lights on, nobody home. Doesn't have both oars in the water, and his elevator sure as hell don't go to the top. Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, you're too kind, too kind. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. I'm here with a little bit of blues this morning, and I'm going to be signing off here in a bit. I just mainly, like I said, this is for Linda Moore out there. God bless you, sweetie. I hope we could hook up somehow even more, you know, because, yeah, you're a special lady. Okay, we're going to listen to a little bit of the old Captain Boomer banging on a git fiddle. A little bit of blues, and like I said, it's really raw. I just put it out there, and as you know, this ain't no fancy studio. I mean, after all, I am broadcasting from an ironing board, you know what I'm saying? So, there you go. Yeah.
Hey, everybody, it's Pee-wee.
Hey, Pee-wee.
What's yours? La, la, la.
All right. Captain's banging it out, hacking up a little bit of blues. Here we go.
Well, is this thing working now, or does it got a...
I don't know.
Well, let's see. Let's see what we got here, anyway. That is some kind of fun tonight. Something constructive, maybe, in the realm of constructability things.